Hi everyone! So if you're planning to have a vacation in Germany, this is the right video for you. So para sa mga applicant na gustong mag-apply ng tourist at saka ng visit visa, I will be mentioning lahat ng steps na gagawin nyo at saka yung mga requirements na kailangan nyong kompletuhin to be able to help you have a visa approved. So the first step would be to determine whether you need a tourist or visit visa. Guys, magkaiba ang tourist at saka ang visit visa. Some of you might think na pareho lang naman yan, pareho lang naman short-term visa. Yan, magkaiba siya in terms of additional requirements. And applying for the wrong visa, pwede kayong ma-denied. Like, your intention is to visit someone and then you apply for tourist visa. And the other way around, balak nyo lang palang mag-tour and then you apply for visit visa. So, pwede kayong ma-deny agad-agad kasi hindi nyo alam yung visa na dapat nyo applyan talaga. So, it can create confusion. For the second step, let's say na-determine mo na kung anong visa category yung ma-match or yung perfect dun sa intention ng trip mo. Nakapili ka na. Then, the next thing that you need to do now is to go to the embassy website. And then, from there, hahanapin nyo lang yung requirement checklist under the visa category that you choose. Para makita nyo kung ano ba yung mga requirements na hinihingi ng embassy to be able to help you have a visa. So, to guide you with all the requirements that you need, I will mention yung mga standard requirements na nire-request ng embassy for both tourist at saka visit visa. So the first requirement is an online visa application form completely filled out and signed by the applicant. So again, I will have a link of the application form in the description and then you will be able to answer it online. And the next requirement is a 2 current biometric passport picture. So for Germany, meron silang sariling format din for passport size picture. I will have a link of the requirements pagdating sa mga picture. Third requirement is original passport and a photocopy of the passport which must be valid for another 3 months after the end of the travel and must have 2 empty pages. So, this is for the immigration para if ever ma-approve yung visa mo, merong space na matatatakhan. Baka naman na-overwhelm ka, hindi nalimutan mo nang i-check yung mga pages, kung meron pa bang available pages. And then the reason bakit ka din deny is kasi wala na nga paglalagyan ng visa mo. So, make sure again guys, check your passport. Dapat walang mga damage. Kailangan hindi pa ma-expire ang passport mo. Kailangan correct details sa passport mo. And pagdating sa photocopy na hinihingi nila, ang kailangan mong ipa-photocopy is yung first page where your information is, yung picture mo, yung complete name, passport number. So yun, ipapa-photocopy nyo. And then next, kailangan nyo ipa-photocopy yung pinaka-last page ng passport nyo. Yun yung part ng passport na nakalagay yung iko-contact in case of emergency together with your signature. And if ever you're a frequent traveler or meron ka ng mga travel history, please do photocopy lahat ng entry stamp dun sa passport nyo. And I advise that you also bring all your old passport if ever nag-renew ka na multiple times. And if you still have it, which I hope you do, please do bring all those passport. But you don't need to photocopy yung mga yon. You just need to bring them with you. Ang alam ko kasi, i-check din ng embassy yon just to see if meron ka na mga previous travels or meron ka bang history ng overstaying, so something like that. So please do bring all your passport. Fourth requirement is a declaration according to 54, medyo mahirap i-pronounce, Aufenthalt. Ang hirap niya i-pronounce. So, you can download this form. It will be in the description below. This is for both tourist and visit visa applicants. So, this form is coming from Germany. I think in German siya, pero merong English translation. So, please do complete the form. And you can download it for free naman. So, please bring that sa application nyo. The next requirement is your flight itinerary reservation with dates and flight number, entry or exit to Germany. I do recommend, guys, not to purchase a ticket agad-agad. So, because we are not sure whether you will have a visa or not. And not all airlines issue a refund if ever you will not be able to take that flight. If ma-denied ka and then you will tell the airlines, oh, na-denied yung visa ko, I would like to have a refund. There's no guarantee they will approve you with that. So, sa pagdating sa mga visa application, it is advisable na kumuha ka lang ng ticket reservation or yung tinatawag natin na dummy ticket. This way, you can save money. At least ma-denied ka man at hindi ka bumili ng real ticket and you will be spending 1,000 or less than that. Depende kung saan ka kukuha ng dummy ticket. If you do need help, if wala kayong alam na pagkukuhanan, I do offer dummy ticket. I will have a link to my website in the description. So go visit that and andun yung offer ko na dummy ticket, how much and then kung paano mag-order. The next requirement is a complete day travel day-to-day itinerary. Again, it's a day-to-day itinerary. Kasi kailangan makita ng embassy yung plano mo from day 1 up until yung pinaka-last day ng trip nyo. So, if you need... Actually, this itinerary, pwedeng ikaw na yung gumawa. If you do not have time, if nahihirapan ka magplano, or yung iba kasi boom, nagpa-purchase na lang ng mga travel plans sa mga travel agency, that's still fine. Pero if you wanted to save money and you wanted to make this trip more personalized and you wanted to do it, I do have a separate video where I will be able to guide you on how I do my itinerary. So para magkaroon kayo ng idea kung ano yung format na ginagawa ko, kung paano ko siya sinisimulan, or ano yung mga dapat na sa itinerary. But you, if you also do need help, again, it's one of the services na in-offer ko sa website ko. If you visit my website, you will see everything there. And then, we go to the next requirement, which is a cover letter stating the purpose of your visit to Germany. The cover letter should have also a brief summary of your itinerary. So, a cover letter, guys, is a must. It is not listed in the requirements. Madalas wala siya sa requirement checklist, but it is required. There are some applicants that get denied kasi wala silang cover letter. So, even it's not in the requirement checklist, please do make a cover letter. And with the letter kasi, pwede nyo i-explain sa embassy yung plano nyo, yung intention nyo, and why you really need to have this visa. This is your only way to convince them that you do deserve to have your visa approved. The next requirement is a travel insurance. So again, travel insurance is a must. Yung iba kasi, ang iniisip nila, kukuha na lang sila ng travel insurance once their visa got approved. Guys, during application, kailangan na ng insurance. There are insurance provider na nag-i-issue ng refund if ever your visa application get denied. So, at least, hindi ka ma-atag dito. Hindi ka na rin lugi. Kung baga mababalik pa rin yung pera sa'yo. I would advise to get your insurance with standard insurance. Actually, I find them yung pinaka-cheap na mag-issue ng insurance. Kasi yung last ko sa kanila ko kay Noah. And you can also get an insurance with AXA and Pacific Cross. Next, the requirement is your proof of accommodation. So, for tourist applicant, ang kailangan mong ipakita is hotel booking or Airbnb, hostel. So, any proof of accommodation under your name, pwede nyong gamitin yan. You can actually book hotels without paying for it agad-agad. Since wala kang assurance na ma-approve at masasayang lang yung pera mo, with booking.com, doon ako nagbubook ng mga ticket ko. You can book it for free without paying for anything and you can cancel it for free without being charged at all. para naman dun sa mga applicant ng visit visa, since you will be applying for a visit visa, it is a must that you have an inviting person and you should have an invitation letter coming from that inviting person. Yung invitation letter, it's an informal letter na kailangan gawin ni inviting person to parang to explain to the embassy yung intention ng trip mo, his background, and some information regarding kung saan siya nakatira, ano yung trabaho niya, how can he assure or she assure the embassy that you will not be overstaying in Germany. And besides invitation letter, there are supporting documents that your inviting person should provide. So, I will have a list of the supporting documents na kailangan niyang ipasa. Or, meron actually akong previous video regarding sa mga requirements or supporting documents na kailangan i-provide ni inviting person at saka ni sponsor. I previously made that video, so please do check that out. And then, the next requirement is a proof of financial funds. Of course, kailangan makita ng embassy that you can support yourself during your travel. At saka meron kang penang gagastusin sa Germany. So for tourist applicant, let's say you can pay or you can support your own travel expenses. Make sure that you will be able to show the embassy a bank account certificate and then 6 months to 1 year banking statement. The certificate, you need to request that sa banko nyo. Because this certificate needs to have a signature and a stamp coming from the bank official para mapatunayan na legit at hindi fake yung mga certificate at saka bank statement na dala-dala nyo. Now, if you are someone that is in this situation na hindi kayang isupport yung own travel expenses nyo, that is still fine. It will not stop you from traveling as long as you have a sponsor that is willing to help you with all your travel expenses. As long as this person is related to you at meron kang mapapakitang proof of relationship, then pwede kanyang sponsoran. If this is just a random people, of course, alanganin. Baka hindi ka ma-approve. Baka pwede ka pang ma-deny just because of that. So, for the sponsor, make sure na si sponsor mag-send sa'yo ng sponsorship letter and a formal obligation. So, yung formal obligation is a certificate na kailangan i-request ng sponsor mo sa municipality kung saan siya naka-register. So, punta lang siya sa municipality as and then itanong lang niya kung paano siya kukuha ng formal obligation kasi mag-a-apply ka ng visa and tutulungan lang sila ng step. Make sure na yung copy is original at saka photocopy. Just in case na ang gusto ng embassy ay original. There are times actually, masyadong demanding ang embassy, ang gusto nila lahat original coming from the sponsor. But then again guys, lahat ng imi-mention ko na documents, lahat ng importante, please do make sure that you have a photocopy, at least one copy each. Para, if ever, during the submission, ang kukunin lang nila is yung mga photocopy at mababalik pa sa'yo yung mga original just in case you would need it for your future applications. Kasi guys, pag nakuha na nila yung original, wala nang balikan yun. For the sponsor, like the inviting person, there are supporting documents that your sponsor need to provide to be able to make the sponsorship valid. So I will have the link of my previous video here. Please do check that out. And then the next requirement is a proof of civil status. So this is to prove if ikaw ay single, if you're married, divorced, or kung ano man yung status mo. Next is, you need to show to the embassy that you have a proof of strong ties. This is proof that you will be returning to the Philippines after your trip. This is very important at madaming na de-denied just because they don't have this. So if you wanted to know what are the things or what are the strong ties na pwede mong gamitin, I do made a previous video of the list ng mga strong ties na pwede mong ipakita sa embassy. Again, I will have it up here. So just to give you a summary, it can be your work, It can be your properties, asset, or if you have cars. So anything that is under your name, actually, that is connecting you from the Philippines, pwede nyo siyang gamitin. If ever you have, let's say, mga anak that is minor, or if you're single but you do have a parents that is a senior citizen or currently ill, inaalagaan mo, ikaw yung nagbabantay sa kanila, you can use that as a family ties. Parang excuse mo sa embassy that you really need to return to the Philippines because you're taking care of your kids or you're taking care of your parents. Again, to prove that, kailangan nyo ng supporting documents ng mga anak nyo at saka medical record or senior ID ng mga parents nyo. The last requirement is yung evidence of employment status. So this is for those people that are employed, self-employed, mga estudyante at saka retiree. I will mention this fast, but I will also have this in the description below para ma-list nyo at makumpleto nyo lahat. So for the employees, make sure that you have a certificate of employment, and then you also have your bank statement up to 6 months, and then make sure you have 3 months recent payslip. And then one of the most important requirement for employees is a leave permission from the employer. If your employer does not approve your vacation, then don't expect the embassy to approve you. Kasi bakit kanila papayagan magbakasyon kung mismong yung work mo hindi ka pinapayagan, 'di ba? I know in the Philippines it's hard, but if ayaw ka na talagang payagan magbakasyon ng mahaba, then maybe the only thing that you can do is to request for a shorter vacation. Next is income tax return. Make sure na meron kang income tax return, and if wala, ma-explain mo sa cover letter mo yung reason why you don't have ITR. In the Philippines, there are some people that is exempted on paying tax. If you're one of those people, then just explain it to the cover letter, because without explanation, they will think that you're not really paying tax just because of what, for random reason. So anything that you don't have, anything that is missing from your requirements, you need to make sure that you will be able to explain that to your cover letter. The next is for those self-employed or yung mga merong small business. Please make sure that you have a copy of your business license or yung DTI. And then you also need a mayor's and barangay business permit. And then, income tax return. Especially yung mga malalaking business, kailangan nyo talagang may ITR. But for those small business owners, yung mga sari-sari store, computer shop, laundry shop, or basta actually yung mga online seller, yung mga merong clothing boutique, makeup boutique, or whatsoever, okay lang na walang ITR. Basta you're earning not more than 250,000 annually. If it's below that, then you're exempted on paying tax. If it's above that, then ibang usapan na yon. You really need to explain to them why you don't have ITR. And then for students, make sure that you have a proof of enrollment, a photocopy of your school ID, and an approved letter from your school or your university. This is if ever ang trip mo is during school days. Kailangan payagan ka ng school mo magbakasyon. But if you are going to have a vacation in Germany during the vacation in the Philippines, then you don't need to provide yung approved letter of absence since bakasyon na nga. Additional requirement would be a proof of enrollment for the coming of for the next school year. Para makita nila na enrolled ka, kaya ka babalik ng Pilipinas. Lastly is for those retirees, mga senior citizen, if wala kang trabaho, okay lang po, basta meron kayong pension statement, all you need to do is show that pension statement for the latest 6 months. So yeah guys, these are the mandatory or yung mga standard requirements under visit at saka tourist visa. I will have a link for the tourist at saka visit visa requirement checklist provided by BFS para makita nyo lahat ng mga ni-mention ko. If balak nyo magbakasyon together with your kids, there are some additional requirements for them. To be able to know that, I do create a previous video on how you can apply for a Schengen visa for minors. So doon naka-explain na lahat din ng steps at saka po ng mga requirements that you would need to complete. since let's say nakompleto niyo na lahat, ready na, nakalagay na siya sa envelope, and all you need to do now is to book an appointment with BFS Global Germany. Hindi sila tumatanggap ng walk-in. So please make sure that you have an approved appointment. If you do need help actually, if nahihirapan kayong mag-set up ng appointment sa BFS, I created previously a video on how you can set an appointment. Iga-guide kayo step by step. So again, I will have it up here. Please do watch that para hindi kayo mahirapan sa pagbubook nyo. Let's say, okay na, book na, approve na. The fourth step that you need to do is to go to your scheduled appointment. So, pagpunta nyo sa embassy or dun sa BFS Global Office, that is the time that you will be submitting your application, you will be getting your biometrics, and as well as pay the visa fee at saka yung processing fee. For the visa at saka service fee, ang visa fee have increased to 80 euro, which is 4,500 pesos. For children age 6 to 12, it's 40 euro. In peso, it's 2,250. So, yun yung amount na i-ready nyo. On top of the visa fee, there is a service fee of 906. Now, let's say okay na, napasa nyo na yung application, nakapagbayad na kayo ng visa fee, nakuha na yung biometrics nyo, then you're ready to go home. And all you need to do now is to wait for a result. During waiting, you can actually track your application. So that's it. Those are the steps and the requirements that you need to do para makapag-apply ng tourist at saka ng visit visa. So I do hope this video helps you pagdating sa mga questions nyo. If you do have some concern or there is something that is confusing, please feel free to leave me a question sa comment below, or you can also message me directly and I'll try my best to answer each of your question. And guys, please do visit my website for all the services na baka maging interesado kayo, so I can guide you with your future visa application. So if you're not yet a subscriber, please do hit that subscribe button and that bell button para maging updated kayo sa mga upcoming ko pang mga video. If you do like this, please do give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you on my next video. Bye!